free will, you can do whatever in life you choose to do. Your circumstances are in the palm of your hand more often than you might think. Meanwhile, understanding our plight, the nuns offered me a job at the convent. Now, I was in fifth grade. I was to scrub floors all day on Saturday on my hands and knees for $2, a box of cheese and powdered milk. The floors were made up of the little bitty towels, and I was scrubbing them with something like Comet, which meant that Comet was getting in the grout, and my responsibility was to get all of that Comet out of the grout before I left at the end of my day. From then on, though, until just a few years ago, I scrubbed every floor in my home on my hands and knees. I was conditioned to understand the significance of being focused on when a job was done well, even if it was just cleaning floors. This life lesson taught me that if you're going to do something, do it well. The quality of your work will always have your name on it. By the age of 24, I became a divorced single mom. I hadn't finished college, and I was working hard to take care of my son. This time was a tremendous challenge for me. I was working at a print company that had begun to hire African Americans to work in the office. All the blacks, however, were assigned to work in the binder. My white co-workers believed that I wasn't good enough to work next to them in the office. And the blacks felt that I was wasting my time pursuing my education. They didn't see the opportunity for advancement for blacks in our company. 3 years later, I finished college. I had advanced my career, acquired support from my white co-workers, and my fellow black workers had become my biggest supporters. If you can't stop her, you might as well plan to join her. This taught me my third life lesson. You must block out all of the negatives, all of the negative noise from all angles. Listening and letting it get to you will eventually confuse and paralyze you from reaching your destiny. Fear